Paschachyateshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going over the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're in chapter number 18, where the residents of Jambudweep are offering prayers to the different forms of the Lord.
So
at this point, prayers are being offered to Matsya, the Lord's incarnation as a fish.
上次我们听到的是, 那里的居民向, 主 Matsya, 一个鱼的化身, 供奉的祷文。
So Mother Lakshmi is offering the prayers, and she's saying that everybody is envious of the authority of the Supreme Lord. Even big demigods, they're envious of Krishna.
即便是半世人,
but without the help of the Supreme Lord, they could never maintain the universe.
但是如果没有至尊主的帮忙的话,
so it's the Supreme Lord who is actually maintaining not only all the human beings, but the animals and the plants and the beasts, all creatures everywhere. They're all maintained by him.
事实上是至尊主在维系着这一切,不是这些人类在维系,所有的人类,树木,鸟儿,这些动物,所有的一切生物,实际上都是被至尊主所维系着。
So we see in the modern times how the scientists, they're trying to compete with God, they're trying to create things in the laboratory.
我们看到现在的一些科学家们，他想和至尊主竞争，他创造一些东西和至尊主竞争。
They try to take the genes, take some genetics, take some genes from one animal and put them in another animal, and in this way they try to create some super animal.
他们把一个动物的基因放到另外一个动物的基因，以此来创造一个超级的动物。So
they try to prove that science is supreme and that science can do better than God.
他们想以此来证明科学比神更为伟大。
But we see that, and even sometimes they claim, you know, they claim that they're helping the poor people. They have some people, there are some people in the world, they claim that they're doing the highest, the most important work by helping the poor people, by feeding the poor people. And they say, Krishna consciousness, you people, you're not doing anything, you're wasting your time.
有一些人他在这个世界上做一些很慈善的活动，他们就认为自己做得很好，然后说你们这些 Krishna 知觉的这些人完全是在浪费时间。And
you got even some swamis, they also do food programs, they give food for the poor, And they say, no need to worship God, just worship the poor people. Don't offer the food in the temple to God, just give the food to the poor people. And they say the poor people, they're actually God.
有一些贫穷的，有一些所谓的这些死亡民们，他们也在供养穷人，他们也去给这些穷人喂食，然后呢，他们甚至还说，不要把食物供奉给庙里面的神像，把食物供奉给那些穷人，把食物供奉给穷人比庙里的神像好。实际上，那些穷人才是神像。But
that doesn't solve any problems in the world. The poor people still remain poor.
但是他们的这些行为并没有解决什么问题，那些穷人还照样是穷人。Actually,
the Supreme Lord is responsible for maintaining everyone.
事实上，至尊主他有责任，他有责承担着责任，维系着所有的人。He
maintains the animals and the birds and the trees, everything.
他维系着人类、动物、鸟类、树木，一切。
So these people who are hungry, who are starving, this is not by chance, but this is something to do with their karma.
有一些人很穷、挨饿，这不是说偶然才发生的，这是由于他们的因果业报才造成的这样的情况。
And so, they want, if you want to change someone's karma, you don't change their karma just by feeding them. You have to give them Krishna consciousness.
如果我们想改变别人的业报的话，我们不仅仅只是说给别人食物，我们应该把 Krishna 知觉给予他们，才能改变他们的业报。But
those people who are demons, those people who are the demons who are atheists, they cannot understand the nature of the management of the universe as it's done under the hands of the Supreme Lord.
这些恶魔们，这些无神论者们，他们无法理解至尊者的这个本性。
And we see even how big demigods like Lord Brahma and Lord Indra also come to, they become very puffed, very proud, and they try to be independent, or they try to surpass Krishna's power.
我们会看到，即便是主 Brahma 和 Indra， 他们有时候也会心生骄傲，最终被主 Krishna 惩罚。
We just had the Govardhan Puja, and that Govardhan Puja, Krishna picking up the Govardhan Hill, took place because Indra had become so proud that he tried to destroy all the people of Vrindavan.
我们刚刚过了噶尔瓦南山瀑布，噶尔瓦南山之所以显现，这个事情之所以发生，是因为因者他非常的骄傲，他甚至想毁灭文达文。He
wanted the people in Vrindavan to make an offering to him, but Lord Krishna didn't want the people in Vrindavan to worship Indra.
他希望文达文的居民能够给他供奉，但是主 Krishna 不希望文达文的居民崇拜Krishna。
Krishna knows the people in Vrindavan are all his very pure devotees, and they're all engaged in his pure loving service. He doesn't want them to worship demigods.
主 Krishna 知道文达文的居民都是 Krishna 纯粹的奉献者，他不希望这些纯粹的奉献者去崇拜一个半神。
Krishna wants to see Vrindavan only the place for just pure devotion to Krishna.
Krishna 希望文达文的居民只是做纯粹的奉献服务给予 Krishna.
So when Krishna told Nanda Maharaj not to do the Indra Yagya, Indra became very angry.
因此，当 Krishna 告诉 Nanda Maharaj 不要做给 Indra 的这个祭祀时， Indra 非常生气。
And so Indra sent all his clouds to go and flood the whole of Vrindavan and wipe out all the cows and all the people. He wanted to destroy everything and everyone there.
因此 Indra 带来了这个他的这个云和闪电， 他想把文达们的所有的一切都给毁灭。
So to save the people, all the people, of course, they all came to Krishna for help to save him. So Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill and gave shelter to everyone. All the cows and all the people, they all came under Govardhan Hill.
因此，为了保护文达们的居民，当然文达们的居民也向 Krishna 寻求庇护。主 Krishna 举起了这个噶尔瓦纳山，所有的居民都跑到噶尔瓦纳山底下寻求庇护。
And Indra's clouds were pouring rain and thunderbolts and wind and trying to destroy for 7 days and seven nights before they finally stopped.
Indra 的这个云就带来了风，还有那个冰下了冰雹，然后这个七天七夜都闪着电，下着大雨。
So after 7 days and nights, Indra had to admit that he was defeated by child Krishna, by the young boy Krishna, who was only 7 years old at the time.
在七天七夜之后 ，Indra 他认为自己被这个七岁的这个小孩 Krishna 给打败了。
So then he began to understand who was actually Krishna.
那个时候他才理解到谁是真正的 Krishna 真正的是什么，是谁。
And even Brahma, who was the supreme in the universe, who was the original person in the universe, the firstborn, he had a problem also. He tried to measure Krishna, he tried to see how, he wanted to test how great is Krishna.
即便是这个宇宙的这个第一位创造者主 Brahma， 他也想测试 Krishna。
Brahma came just after Krishna had killed Agasura. Lord Brahma came and he was really amazed to see how Krishna had defeated and killed this big demon Agasura. So then Brahma got up to some tricks and he stole away cowherds, all the cowherd boys and the cows from Krishna.
当 Krishna 杀了 Agasura 这个魔的时候，主 Brahma 非常的惊讶，这个小孩竟然能把这么伟大的恶魔给杀死。于是主 Brahma 这个时候就想了解，就想测试给 Krishna， 他把 Krishna 身边的母牛和牧牛童们全都给拿走了。
So that was a great offense on the part of Brahma. He took away all the devotees, all those cows and all the cowherd boys. They're all devotees.And they're associates of Krishna, and Brahma took them all away from Krishna.
主 Brahma 实际上做了一个很大的冒犯，他把 Krishna 的牧牛童、奶牛都拿走了，而这些都是主 Krishna 亲密的这些童友，他把主 Krishna 的奉献者给夺走了，这是对 Krishna 的一个冒犯。
Brahma thought, "Well, I only took them for a moment, but one moment of his time."Was 1 year on this planet.
主 Brahma, 当时拿走了一瞬间，但是他的那一瞬间对于地球上的是一年。
And for 1 year, Krishna took the place of all the cows and all the cowherd boys. Krishna expanded himself. He personally became all the cowherd boys and all the cows.
在这一年之中。主 Krishna 亲自扩展他自己，成为牧牛童以及奶牛。他扩展自己，成为这些牧牛童和奶牛。
And when Brahma came back, and then he saw that all the cows and the cowherd boys were all there, he was just amazed. He couldn't believe it because he thought he had stolen them. He didn't know this was Krishna taking their place.
当主 Brahma 再回来看的时候。他非常的惊讶，他发现这些奶牛和牧牛童竟然还在这儿，他完全不理解，这是 Krishna 在扩展了他自己成为的这些牧牛童和奶牛。
So in this way, Brahma was his pride was crushed by the power of Krishna.
在这种方式下。 主 Brahma 的这种骄傲就被主 Krishna 给抹灭掉，给打击了。
Krishna doesn't let his devotees become proud or puffed up. He corrects them for that.
Krishna 不希望他的奉献者变得骄傲， Krishna 会亲自纠正他们。
Okay, so then the prayers continue to Matsya, and it's described how at the end of the millennium, the earth planet falls into the water and it goes underneath all the water at the bottom of the universe.
这个祷文继续到，在这个年代之末，这个地球被洪水给泛滥，就是遭遇了洪水之灾。
Right, and the earth planet is the source, it's an important planet because it's from the earth. They get many herbs and drugs and different trees. It's very valuable.
这个地球实际上是非常有价值的，有各种各样的香草、药材，还有树木，这些非常有价值。
So at that time, Lord Matsya protected the earth and he roamed the sea. He traveled in the sea with great speed.
那个时候主 Matsya 保护了地球，他连同这个地球急速地漫游在这个 海面上。
So the devotee offers prayers to Matsya that you are actually the maintainer of the universe.
奉献者们向主 Matsya 祷告道，实际上您是整个宇宙的创造的真正的维系者。
You are the cause of all the living entities.
您是所有生物的源泉。
And I offer my obeisances unto you.
我向您致以虔敬的顶拜。
So people who are not devotees, they have difficulty to understand how the Lord can perform this work of creation and maintenance and destruction of the universe.
人们如果不是奉献者的话，他们很难理解他主可以创造、维系和毁灭这个宇宙。
But for a devotee, it's not difficult to see this.
但是对奉献者要理解这些并不是很难。
Devotee sees how the Lord is behind everything. He's controlling the whole material nature.
奉献者能够看到主在一切之后。在一切的背后，他维系着这一切。
Everything is moving, just like a shadow moves under the control of the object. So the material energy is like the shadow of the potency of the Supreme Lord.
就像影子在主体的这个情况下在动一样，实际上物质自然也在这个主体，而这个主体就是至尊主的影响下行动。
So all the changes in nature, they're also taking place under the control of the Supreme Lord.
所有的一切都在至尊主的控制之下。
But the people who are not devotees, they cannot understand, but devotee understands.
奉献者们不理，非奉献者们不理解这一切，但是奉献者们理解这一切。
Because the devotees are humble. They don't have to be educated. Even if they're not educated, they can understand how the Lord is behind everything.
因为奉献者非常谦卑，即便他没有受过什么教育，他仍然知道这一切都在至尊主的背后的，这一切的背后都是至尊主的控制。
So we're going now to another section of Jambadvip. This section is called Haranmaya Varsha.
下面我们去到江布对普的另外一个 Varsha， 这个地方叫 Haranmaya Varsha。
And Lord Vishnu lives there in the form of a tortoise, Kurma avatar.
主 Vishnu 在那个地方以乌龟的这个形象化身显现着，他这个名字叫 Kurma Sharira。
And that the Lord is always worshipped there by his devotee Aryama.
主在那里被他的奉献者崇拜着，这里首要的居民是 Aryama。
Aryama is the chief resident。
Aryama 是那里的首要的居民。
So the Lord is described that he's very attractive, even though he's in the form of a tortoise, but still he's attractive.
这里描述到，即便主是以这种乌龟的形象，他仍然是具有强大的吸引力。
People who are not devotees, they hear about the Lord, how he is a boar, how he is a fish, how he is a tortoise, and they think these are not very nice. These are not beautiful things.
有一些人，非奉献者会认为主是乌龟、雄猪和鱼的化身的话。并不觉得这些化身是很美丽的一件事情。
But they don't know how the Lord is full of all opulences, and one of the opulences is that he is very beautiful.
但是他们不知道主是全面富裕的，而全面富裕的第一个特征是具有全然的美丽。
One of the devotees who was an artist.She was painting the picture of the Lord as the boar incarnation, and she asked Prabhupada how to paint it because it won't look very nice because it's a boar.
有一个奉献者，他在给主的化身做画画的时候，他问到圣帕帕德，他说如何画这个主雄猪的化身呢？因为这是个雄猪，不是很难描述它的美丽。
But Prabhupada told her how the Lord is always attractive, even though when he comes as a boar, he's still attractive.
但是圣帕帕德告诉他，即便主是雄猪的化身的时候，他仍然是具有全然的美丽的。
So we cannot see with our material eyes. We have to see with spiritual vision.
我们不能用我们物质的眼光去看待这一切，应该用灵性的视野去看待。
We have to see how this is the form of the Lord, and the Lord is always attractive, always beautiful.
我们应该看到这个形体，它是至尊主，而至尊主是永恒的美丽，永远美丽，永远吸引力。
And so they always engage in full, pure, unalloyed devotional service.For the pleasure of the Lord.
奉献者永远做着纯粹的奉献服务，给予主。
So Aryama prays to Lord Kurma. He says, "You are the reservoir of all transcendental qualities."
Aryama 向库尔玛。祈祷道：“您是所有超然品质的储藏库。
You are situated in pure goodness.
您完全的处在纯粹的善良之中。
And you move through the water, but no one can understand about what you're doing or where you're going or where you are.”
您在水中移动，但是没有人能知道您是谁，您在做什么。
You are not limited by time. You're present everywhere.
您不被时间所限制，您在任何地方显现。
So we have to offer obeisances to you.
因此我向您致以虔敬的顶拜。
So, Prabhupada quotes Brahma Samhita. He said, the Lord, he is always in Goloka. That's the topmost planet in the spiritual world.
Prabhupada 引述 Brahma Samhita 的一个世界说，主永恒的在这个世界的最高星宿葛罗卡。
But at the same time, he's all pervading. He's everywhere.
但与此同时，他遍存万有，他在所有的地方。
This is the opulence of the Supreme Lord.
这就是至尊主的富裕。
Although he is everywhere, he cannot be seen with ordinary eyes.
尽管他遍存万有，但是以我们物质的眼光却看不到他。
Nobody knows exactly where to find him, where he is.
没有人知道他在什么地方，没有人能够找到他，找得到他。
This is the greatness of the Supreme Lord.
这是至尊主的伟大所在。
This is his inconceivable potency.
这也是他不可思议的力量，能量。
So Aryama continues, he said, this whole material world is your energy.
这个他继续祈祷道，整个宇宙是您的能量的展示。
And all the varieties of forms, all the different forms which are in this world are just simply your energy, your external energy, your material energy.
各种无数的无数种类的这种形象都只是您的外在能量，您的物质能量的展示。
And the Virata Roop, the universal form, that's not your real form.
Virata Roop, 宇宙形体不是您的真实形体。
But only devotee can see your real form.
只有您的奉献者能够看到您真正的形象。
So, see, the materialists, the Mayavadis, they think the universal form is the real form.
Mayavadi 和物质主义者认为这个宇宙形体是真实的。
And they think Krishna's form, that is illusion.
They think Krishna's form is illusion.
Yeah.
他们认为 Krishna 的形象是虚幻的。
So they've got it the wrong way around.
所以他们是错误的。
Yeah, they should understand Krishna's form is real and the universal form is illusion.
他们应该明白 Krishna 的形象才是真实的，宇宙形象是虚幻的。
The universal form is just a temporary display of opulence of the material world.
这个宇宙形象只是至尊主富裕的短暂展示而已。
But the form of Krishna, that is Satchit Ananda Vigraha, eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
但是主 Krishna 的形象是 Satchit Ananda Vigraha, 永恒知识和极乐的。
So Srila Prabhupada gives a nice example to understand this mistake which people make.
圣帕帕德给了一个非常美好的一个非常好的例子。这些物质主义人他们所做的这个措施。
He said, just like a fire. With a fire, there is heat and light, and there's the fire itself also.
火有三个要素，有火的能量，有火的热量和光，还有火本身。
The heat and the light, they have no form, but they are the energy of the fire.
热量和光，它们没有形象，它们只是火的能量而已。
So they're not really real.
它不是真实的。
But the fire, that has a form, that is actually real.
但是火，它是有真实的形象的，火是真实的。
And the heat and light, that's the energy coming from the fire.
热量和光是来自于火。
So the impersonal conception of the Lord, the impersonal conception is like the expansion of heat and light from the fire.
非人格主义者就像火的热量和光一样，他们的这个概念。
Yeah, the impersonal feature, the Brahma Jyoti, that comes from the body of Krishna.
非人格的特征，实际上这个梵光实际上是主 Krishna 身体的散发的光。
So the material creation is all Krishna's energy.
整个物质宇宙是 Krishna 的能量。
But you don't find Krishna's form here in the material world.
但是我们没有发现主 Krishna 的形象在这个物质世界。
This is Krishna's inconceivable power.
这是主 Krishna 不可思议的力量。
So nobody can understand the real form of the Lord without being a devotee.
除非成为奉献者，没人能理解主 Krishna 真正的形体。
So Aryama continues offering prayers to the tortoise, Lord Kurma. He says,
Aryama 继续、
Go ahead.
Aryama 继续向 Kurma 祈祷道。
And he says how Lord Kurma manifests many different energies in many different forms.
他祈祷道，从主的形体产生了很多的能量，还有很多的生物。
All the different living entities, he's the cause of all, the birth of all the different living entities in the material world.
您是一切生物，这个物质地球上生物的缘由。
So there's four different ways in which living entities take birth in the material world.
在这个物质世界有四种方式，这些生物四种方式出生产生。
First of all, you've got living entities who are born from the womb, like the humans. We take birth from the womb.
就像我们人类是从子宫中产生，第一种方式是从子宫中产生。
But other forms of life, just like cows and dogs, and when they give birth, you know, their offspring also come from the womb.
还有这些奶牛，还有狗，它们也是从子宫中产生。
But some other living entities, they take birth from eggs.
有一些是从蛋里面产生。
Birds, particularly birds, chickens, hens, ducks.Eagles, they all come from eggs.
比如说鸡鸭，它们都是从蛋里面产生。
And then you've got some living entities. They take birth from perspiration, just from the sweat in the body. Then some living entities they would take their birth.
还有一些它是从汗液之中产生，就流的这个汗，它就可以产生一些生物。
Right? Insects, germs, bugs, little things. And then you've got,
比如说有一些昆虫。
You've got others, they grow out from the ground, like trees and plants. They all come out from the earth.
还有一些植物、树木，它们是从地球的土地上生产。
So everything that we see, the heavenly planets, the earth planets, and everything on the planets, like the rivers and hills and oceans, they are all manifestations of the energy of the Supreme Lord.
所有的一切，包括天堂星球内在的这些星系，包括所有的一切山川、河流、大海等等，这些实际上都是主的不同的能量的展示。
All the stars that we see in the sky and all the planets in space, they're all the energy of the Supreme Lord.
所有的星星，还有海洋，还有各种星球，都是主的能量。
So this world is not false. This world is very real.
这一切都是真实的，不是虚假的。
But of course, we know this material world is temporary. It's not eternal.
但是我们也知道，这一切都是短暂的，不是永恒的。
And it's also.It shows us the inconceivable energy of the Supreme Lord.
我们也理解到这一切都是至尊主不可思议的能量。
So you know, impersonalists, they talk about this world as being unreal, and they say only the Brahman is truth. Only the Brahman, the spirit, is actually true. The material world is all false. It's not real.
非人格主义者他们认为除了 Brahman 以外所有的一切都是虚假的 只有 Brahman 是真实的
And Buddhism also, they also teach that. They say this world is unreal, it's not real. And they say we are not real, we don't really exist, we're also illusion.
佛教徒也有这个理论, 他们说我们都不是真实的, 我们所有这一切都是虚假的, 你不是真实的, 我也不是真实的。
But on the basis of this verse, we can see nothing is false, everything is real.
通过这一个时节, 我们可以看到, 没有什么是不真实的, 一切都是真实的。
It may be temporary, but it's very real.
他们或许是短暂的, 但是是真实的。
Prabhupada gives the example, he said, just like somebody may get angry, they may get angry for some time, it's temporary, but it's real.
圣帕帕德也给出了一个例子，比如说有人愤怒了一段时间，但是他的愤怒是真实的，只是很短。虽然他的愤怒是很短暂，但是愤怒是真实的，不是假的。
You cannot say the anger is not real. It's very real.
我们不能说他的愤怒是不存在的，他的愤怒是存在的，当时。
So you've got these four different types of living entities taking birth.
我们刚刚谈了四种产生的方法，这些生物四种产生的方法。
So these bodies are given to us according to our karma.
他们的躯体来自于他们的业报和活动。
And we have to remain in that body to suffer or enjoy whatever pain or pleasures we're supposed to according to our karma.
根据我们的业报，我们在这个躯体里面待一段时间。 保持享受和遭受痛苦。
So the Lord's energy is like that. Sometimes it's present and sometimes it's not present.
主的能量就是这样，有时候展示，有时候不展示。
Just like the sun. Sometimes the sun is there, sometimes it's not. In the night it's gone. In the daytime the sun comes, in the night it's not there.
就像太阳一样，太阳在白天的时候升起，在晚上的时候落下。
But the sun is always present. It's just that sometimes it's visible, other times it's not visible.
太阳永远都在那儿，只是有时候我们看得见，有的时候我们看不见。
So Aryama continues that he says that the Lord's name and form and bodily features are unlimited, they have many, many different forms.
Aryama 继续祈祷道，说主您的名字、形象、躯体特征是无数无限的，你有无数的这些名字、形象和特征。
Yeah. Nobody knows exactly how many forms the Lord has.
没有人能确定您到底有多少的形象、名字和特征。
But when the Lord comes as Kapiladev, in his incarnation as Kapiladev, at that time he analyzes the cosmic manifestation.
当主您以卡皮拉德瓦显现的时候，您分析24种这些展示的元素。
And at that time, Lord Kapila describes the 24 different elements of the material creation.
您分析包含24种元素的宇宙展示。
So if somebody is interested in Sankhya philosophy, then he can understand more about the nature of these elements.
如果一个人对Sankhya哲学很感兴趣的话，他可以借助这门哲学了解这些元素，不同的元素。
But if he wants to understand the Sankhya philosophy, he has to hear it from Lord Kapila.
如果他想了解 Sankhya 的哲学的话，他应该从 Kapila Deva 那里去聆听。
So Aryama says that the non-devotees, those people who are not devotees, they can see, they count the elements, the 24 elements, but they cannot see how the Lord is behind all of these elements.
阿亚曼继续说道，那些非奉献者们，他们或许可以了解到不同的元素，但是他对元素背后的灵却一无所知。
They can only see the material energy, they cannot see the spiritual form of the Lord behind the material creation.
他们只可以看到这些物质的能量，但是不能看到物质能量背后您的至尊的存在。
But scientists and philosophers have been trying to understand the material world. They've been trying for a very long time.
这些哲学家和科学家们花了很长的时间在研究这个宇宙。
They try to understand it by the power of their own mind and senses.
他们理解这个宇宙是通过他们自己的心意和感官去理解的。
The scientists, the philosopher, they do so much, they spend their whole life trying to understand the material world.
哲学家和科学家们，他们甚至花掉他们一生的时间去了解整个宇宙。
And in course of time, of course, the scientist and the philosopher, they die. I mean, the material nature is still there.
当时间到来的时候，这些科学家、哲学家们就会死去，但是这个物质仍然存在的，物质自然。
And the laws of nature, they go on working. They don't care about the scientist or the philosopher.
自然界的法律会继续下去，他们不会在意这些科学家们和哲学家们的情况。
So the material world is created, and it maintains for millions of years, and then after the maintenance period is over, there will be the annihilation.
当物质世界中发生了无数的变化，直到整个经历了数亿万年。到因的时候，这个宇宙就会被解体。
When it's annihilated, then everything goes into the unmanifest state. Everything is absorbed into the body of Mahavishnu.
当一切被解体的时候，就处在一种不展示的状态，所有的一切都进入到 Mahavishnu 的体内。
Just like there is day and night. So when the night comes, everything is dark. And then the next morning, again the day comes. Begin a new day.
就像白天和夜晚，到晚上的时候，所有的一切都是黑暗的。但是到另外一天的时候，又重新开始。
So the material world is going on like this. There's always creation and destruction, creation, destruction.
物质世界也是像这样不断的创造毁灭，创造毁灭。
And material scientists, they are trying to understand what's happening. They cannot understand how the Lord is behind everything, creating, arranging everything.
物质世界的科学家们想了解到底发生了什么，但是他们始终不理解这一物质世界的这个背后主在操纵的这一切。
Their ability to understand the material world is very limited.
他们理解这个物质世界的这个能力是非常有限的。
But if they would hear from the devotee, if they would listen to the devotee, or if they could read the scriptures, then they could understand.
但是如果他们从奉献者的那里去聆听，从经典那里去学习的话，他们就可以理解这一切。
But they don't have the intelligence to understand these things.
他们没有智力去理解这一切。
Their intelligence is limited.
他们的智力非常有限。
They take so much effort, so much labor, spend so much time, spend so much money, and they can understand nothing.
他们花了很多的时间，很多的钱，还有很多的精力，但是呢，他们一无所获。
So now we're next incarnation we're going to hear about is the boar incarnation, Lord Varaha.
下面我们要了解到猪的另一个雄猪的化身。
He lives in the land called Uttarakuru Varsha.
他住在 Uttarakuru Varsha 这片地方。
And Mother Earth and all the inhabitants worship him there.
地球母亲和其他的居民在那里服务他。
And they chant mantras from the chant a mantra from the Upanishad.
他们从乌帕尼沙德中唱诵祷文曼陀罗。
And they say to the Lord that they say that simply by chanting mantras we will be able to understand you fully.
他们祈祷道，仅仅是依靠唱诵曼陀罗，我们就能够充分的理解您。
They say to Lord Varaha, "You are yagya, sacrifice."
他向向瓦尔哈祈祷道，您是 yagya, 您是祭祀。
And you are kratu, the ritual.
您是 kratu, 仪式。
And all the rituals that we do, all the rituals are part of your transcendental body.
所有的仪式只是您，都是您超然的躯体中的一部分。
You are the real enjoyer of all sacrifice, of all yagya.
您是所有祭祀的唯一享受者。
And you are known as Triyuga, because in Kali Yuga, you appear in a covered incarnation.
您以 Triyuga 著称，因为 Triyuga因为在卡利年代，您以隐秘的化身显现。
So you can see Lord Chaitanya is also mentioned here in this verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以我们可以看到，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 也在这里被提到了，在圣典博迦瓦坛在被提及到了。
Lord Chaitanya is not a regular Lila avatar.
主柴塔尼亚不是常规的 Lila Avatar 的这种化身。
Lord Chaitanya is a concealed incarnation of the Lord. He doesn't come as an incarnation. He doesn't come to reveal himself. He comes as a devotee.
主柴塔尼亚他不是这种 Lila Avatar， 他是一种隐秘的化身，他以一种奉献者的形象显现。
But sometimes we also describe Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.As being the Yuga Avatar.
有时候我们也说主柴塔尼亚马哈布他是 Yuga Avatar 年代化身。
And it's mentioned like that in the 11th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
而这个在圣典博迦瓦坛的第十一篇被描述到。
Karavajana Muni is explaining about the incarnations of the Lord in each Yuga to Maharaj Nimi. Karavajana Muni,
他描述了主的不同年代的化身。
To Maharaj Nimi,
向 Maharaj Nimi 王 描述。
Nimi had asked him, describe, tell me about the Lord's incarnations in each age.
他描述了主在不同年代的化身。
So when he came to Kali Yuga, he described Krishna Varnam Tivishap Krishnam Sangopangastra Parshidam Yagnae Sankirtan Prae Yajantihi Sumedatha. In the Kali Yuga, the Lord will come in a color which is not blackish and he will do the Sankirtan Yagya.
他描述到在卡利年代主不是以一种黑色的颜色的肤色显现。而且他会做 Sankirtan Yagya 提诵圣名的祭祀。
And he will come along with his associates. And those people who are intelligent, they will take part in the Sankirtan movement.
他会和他的 同游们一起来显现，那些有智慧的人他会参加到加入到他们的行列之中。
So when Lord Chaitanya went to Jagannath Puri, the one devotee Gopinath Acharya was telling Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya that Lord Chaitanya is the incarnation of the Lord, he's the Supreme Lord, personality of Godhead.
当主 Chaitanya 到 Jagannath Puri 的时候， Gopinath Acharya 向 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说，主 Chaitanya 他是至尊主的一位化身。
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, no, he cannot be God. God only comes in three yugas. God is called Tri-yuga. He doesn't come in the Kali-yuga.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说他不是至尊主，因为主被称为 Tri-yuga， 他只在三个年代中显现。
But Gopinath Acharya told him, no, you're wrong. The Lord comes in every age. Sambhavami yuge yuge. He will come in every age.
但是 Gopinath Acharya 说，不，你说的不对。主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌也说，每一个年代他都亲自显现。
So he pointed out the Lord comes, he doesn't come as a Leela avatar, but he comes, you know, he's a Yuga avatar, and he's also a concealed avatar.
他虽然不以 Leela avatar 的显现，但是他以一种隐秘的化身显现。
Right. He comes as a devotee, because he knows in the Kali Yuga many people will want to pretend that they're God, so he doesn't come as God.
他不以主的形象显现，他以一种奉献者的显现，因为主知道在这个卡利年代，每一个人都在假扮自己，认为自己是主本人，都在扮演自己是主。
Okay, so I'll just do one more verse. So sometimes the great saints, great yogis and mystics, they will do a fire yagya, and they can make the fire from sticks. They just rub sticks together and produces fire. They don't use matches or anything. They make the fire just by rubbing sticks together.
这些有一些圣人和这些神秘主义神秘瑜伽师们，他们在做祭祀的时候，他们只是把这些木头们放在一起，就可以让这些木头产生火。
Because fire is within wood, there is the element of fire within wood, and when you leave it, then it will just sometimes the fire will just break out, burst out from the wood.
因为在木头中就存在这个火的元素，你只是把这个木头放在那，有些时候这个木头就会自燃起来。
So in the same way, people who know about the absolute truth, they can see the Supreme Lord in everything, even in their own bodies.
同样的道理，那些理解至尊绝对真理的人，他能够在一切之中见到这个您。即便是在他自己的身体之中。
But the people who try to know you, who are not devotees, who are just trying to use their mental and physical ways to they cannot know you.
但是那些非奉献者们，企图通过自己的心意或躯体去理解您的人，他理解不了您，理解不了主。
The Lord won't reveal himself to them.
主不会向他们揭示他们，主不会向他们揭示自己。
Because the Lord only reveals himself to a person when he sees he's very genuine trying to understand the Lord. When he's actually qualified to see the Lord, then the Lord can reveal himself.
因为主会当主看到一个人全心全意的在寻求他。或者说，觉得他很有资格的时候，他才会揭示他自己。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Naham prakasya sarvatma yogamaya sanmavrita mudoyam nabijanati lokamama jamavyayam." Krishna says, "I am never manifest, to the foolish and the unintelligent. For them I am covered by my eternal creative potency.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，我从不向那些愚人和没有智慧的人揭示我自己。对于他们，我以这种我永恒的能量遮蔽我自己。
So in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also said, when one is actually in knowledge, he will surrender to me.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也说，当一个人有知识的时候，他会向我臣服。
So when someone can understand that the Lord is in everyone's heart, then he can actually see the Lord everywhere.
当一个人能明白主在每一个人的心中的时候，他才可以看到主遍存万有。
So that is the goal of knowledge. That is the perfection of knowledge.
这就是知识的目标，这就是知识的完美。
So just like people rub the wood together, they get fire. So
就像
Yeah, the same way, everything we eat is digested by fire.
就像木头摩擦产生火，我们吃的一切消化的时候，也是通被火所消化，为火所消化。
The fire in the stomach is that's the power of digestion.
为火是消化一切的力量。
And if you don't have a good fire in the stomach, then you don't have a good appetite. You can't eat much.
如果你的胃火不够有力量的话，你吃不了很多的东西，你的胃口不好。
So the devotee actually understands how the Lord is everywhere, in everything, and within the heart of all living entities.
奉献者他知道主在一切之中，在一切生物体之中，他在每一个生物体的心中。
The Lord is the overseer, he's a witness to all of their activities. He can see everything we're doing. He knows everything.
主是见证者，他见证着所做的生物所做的一切的事情。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna described the Upadrashta Anumantascha, that he is as a super soul, and the Lord in the heart, he oversees and he is the permitter of the different activities of the living entities.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，我以超念的形式居住在每一个生物体的心中，我是见证者，也是准许者。
But at the same time, the Lord is transcendental to all these material qualities.
Sorry?
The Lord always remains transcendental to all material situations.
在任何的情况，物质的情况之下，主总是保存着他的超然品质，
Although he is everywhere and in everything,He is not affected, he is not contaminated by the material energy.
即便他遍存万有，他仍然不被这些物质能量所污染、所影响。
Because it's his energy, he's in control of the energy, it's all under his direction.
因为这物质能量是他的能量，他控制着这一切的物质能量。
When Vyasa was meditating,Vyasa saw the material energy under the full control of the Lord.
当维亚萨德瓦在冥想的时候，他冥想到一切的物质能量被主控制着。
So Vyasadeva offers his respects to the Supreme Lord Krishna, who is the controller of this whole cosmic manifestation.
所以维亚萨德瓦向至尊主。供奉祷文，他是主，是一切的控制的源头。
Okay, we will stop there.
好，我们停在这儿。
We'll ask if there's any questions.
Yes, first question from Shama. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的莲花组，感谢翻译和主持人，请问 Krishna 会拿走像 Indra 那样的伟大半神的骄傲？我们身上也有很多不好的品质，要具备什么样的资格才能让 Krishna 帮我们拿走呢？谢谢您。 Hare Krishna obeisance to Guru Maharaj. I want to ask, Krishna can take away the Indra's pride. And we also have so many bad qualities. So when we have what kind of quality we have, then Krishna will take our these bad qualities.
What kind of qualities do we need to have so that Krishna will take them away?
What kind of qualities we should have like Indra, then Krishna will take our bad qualities like Indra, because Krishna personally take the Indra's bad qualities. So how can we like Indra?
Well, remember Indra's in a very big position, so he's a big devotee. You know, you're a very small devotee. So Krishna doesn't care so much about little devotees like us. But Indra is in a very big position, so Krishna can say he doesn't want to see his important devotees in Maya.
Krishna not consider us.
Yeah, right.
Krishna 不会在意我们的这个情况是否处在 Maya 之中。
We're just little insignificant personalities.
我们只是一些很微不足道的个体生物而已。
But Indra is the king of heaven. He has a big responsibility.
但是 Indra 他是天堂之王, 他 承担着很大的责任。
You want Krishna to come and take care of you and correct you when you get in Maya?
你希望 Krishna 来亲自 帮助你 纠正你 当你处在 Maya 之中的时候 Krishna 能亲自帮助你吗?
Krishna may deputize someone to act on his behalf to do that.
Krishna 可能会让他的一些奉献者来帮助你做这个事情.
Yeah, he'll send somebody out, not a demigod. Or Krishna won't do it himself, but he'll arrange for somebody else to make us humble, to take away our pride.
Krishna 不会亲自来拿走你的这些骄傲，他会派一些奉献者来拿走你的这些骄傲。
Yeah, he won't do it personally himself, but he will arrange for someone.
他不会亲自做，但是他会安排一些人这么去做。
Are you ready for that?
你准备好了吗?
哼哼。 Okay.
Okay. Next question from Bindu Madhava, Bai Pabu, Bindu Madhava. Dimbai Guruday, 看到不少的奉献者参加了很多的课程，学了很多的哲学，但是似乎变得更骄傲，对其他人总是抱有评判挑剔的眼光，即使自己内省自我，也发现，如果我在某一方面比较优秀，也会对一方面不如我的奉献者怀有骄傲之心。 请问这种骄傲是自然的人性，我们应该暂时接受，还是它是奉献服务中巨大的障碍，需要立即被克服？如果是这样，又如何才能在提高自己服务技能的同时，保持不谦卑不骄傲？Very complete. Basis to Guruday. I see many devotees take part in many courses and learn a lot of philosophies, but it seems that they become more proud, and they are more proud than before. So when I look myself in my heart, I also find in some way I'm very good, So in this, in this way, sometimes I also feel some proud. So this proud is the nature of our human beings. Shall we temporarily accept this condition, or we should be corrected immediately? And if so, this is the first question. Shall we temporarily accept it, or should be corrected immediately?
Well, if one has pride in relation to Krishna, that's not wrong.
如果一个人他的骄傲是和 Krishna 有连接的话, 并没有错。
Yeah, if your pride is, you know, that I'm proud to be a devotee of Krishna, I'm proud to, you know, to chant Hare Krishna, like that's okay.
如果你认为我是 Krishna 的一个奉献者，我在唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，这是可以的。
But if we get carried away by that pride, if we become so proud that we're offensive in dealing with other people, then it's a problem.
如果我们在和其他奉献者在相处的时候带着这种骄傲的话，这是一个问题。
The important point is that we should be happy and appreciate the good fortune to be connected to Krishna.
核心的要点是我们应该欣赏我们和 Krishna 的处在连接的这种状态的时候，我们应该欣赏这种与 Krishna 的连接。
But at the same time, we should be very careful in our dealings with other people, that we don't offend anybody.
但同时我们应该很小心地和其他人相处，这是非常应该值得非常小心的。
So if the pride is wrong, if the pride is not proper, Krishna will arrange to correct that.
如果这个骄傲是不合适的话, Krishna 会安排有人来纠正他。
So there is a saying, we have a saying in English, they say pride comes before the fall. So if our pride is based on our own material satisfaction, then it's not very good. If our pride is to think of ourselves as better than others, it's not good.
骄傲来自于英语谚语里面有一句话，我也翻译不是特别好。骄傲在错误之前，就是说，如果这个骄傲会认为我们的物质感官，骄傲是因为物质感官享乐的话，是不太好的。But
if our pride is that I'm a devotee of Krishna, that's okay.
但如果骄傲的认为我是 Krishna 的一个奉献，这种骄傲会认为我是 Krishna 的一个奉献者的话，这是可以的。
I'm lucky. Somehow I got the mercy of Krishna. I could get seed of devotion. I could practice Krishna consciousness.
或者说我很幸运，我可以得到 Krishna 的仁慈，我可以修习 Krishna 知觉。
So we consider ourselves very fortunate.
以此的这种情况，我们认为自己是很幸运的。
And we think, you know, we got mercy that maybe we didn't deserve.
我们也会认为我们得到的这种仁慈，我们不 are deserved to get this mercy.
No, we did not deserve it.
我们不应该觉得我们值得得到这样仁慈，我们觉得自己并没有这，并不应该享受这么大的仁慈。
嗯。 What's the rest of the question?
Rest of the question is how to improve our how to be humble and not proud while improving our service skills.
Well, always chant the holy name.
总是唱诵圣名。
Offer all respects to others.
总是向别人保持尊敬，供奉自己的尊敬给别人。
Don't be anxious to get respect for yourself.
不要很焦虑的想从别人那里得到这种尊敬。
Meditate on the third verse of Shikshastikam.
冥想八训规的第三个十节。
So that will help us.
这就能够帮助我们。
Okay. Any other question?
Yes, from Rajendra Prabhu. 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜翻译，顶拜主持。请问念诵能有物质的改变吗？ Obeisance to Guru. I want to ask, when we're chanting, there are some material chant?
We hope so.
希望如此。
Chanting brings about change in our material nature, that we will become, you know, the heart will be purified, the heart will be cleansed. So we will improve our character and qualities.
唱诵，我们希望唱诵能够改变我们的物质本性。能够净化我们的内心，能够净化我们的内心。
We see some devotees before they became devotees, they were always very arrogant and proud, and after they become devotees, they become humble.
我们看到有一些奉献者在唱诵之前、念诵之前，他非常的骄傲，但是呢，唱诵一段时间之后，他变得谦卑了。
Yeah, I know some devotees.You know, the wife told me, oh, my husband, before he was a devotee, he was so proud and arrogant. I had a terrible time with him. He was always nasty and angry. And now he's very humble. Changed.
有一些奉献者告诉我，这个Mataji 告诉我，当我的丈夫以前是非奉献者的时候，他总是非常的骄傲。但是他念诵之后变得谦卑，也不是那么的愤怒。
Okay.
This is Shama, who asked the questions before. She said, "Good day, 我准备好了，让奉献者把我不洁的品质都拿走吧。
很好，
很好。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Nila Rasam David Dasi. 顶拜 Guru， 请问我身体不佳，不能服务崇拜神像怎么办 ？Obeisance to Guru， I want to ask. My body condition is not good. Cannot worship the deities.How to do?
Maybe you have to get somebody else to come and worship them for you.
你可以找一些其他的奉献者能够帮助你来崇拜神像。
Or maybe you have to give the deity to somebody else to worship.
或者你可以把神像给予其他奉献者，让别人来崇拜。
What kind of deity is it? Is it photos?
你的神像是
Or is it?
你的神像是照片还是说是别的
？Hare Krishna， 他服务的神像是照片，不是立体神像。
Uh-huh. Okay, so she can worship in her mind.
你可以在心意中崇拜。
Even if you're not able to do it by standing, you can do it sitting.
你如果站着不能崇拜的话，你可以坐着。
You still have to eat. So somebody has to cook for you. So whatever they cook, you should offer to the, your pictures.
你现在还在吃，所以无论你吃什么，别人无论你做什么，就是说别人给你做饭的话，让这个食物要供奉给你的照片的这个神像。
And do what you can. The standard in worshipping pictures usually it doesn't have to be too high.
你做你尽可能做的事情，因为崇拜神，崇拜这个神像照片不是很高。通常情况下。
Yeah. More question?
Yes. Next question from Darcy.顶拜孤乳，我开始修习 Krishna 之觉后，周围人说我对很多物质事物都淡漠不在乎了，学习物质技能时也变得麻木迟钝了，有时候假我具有欺骗性的，我还是很新的奉献者，我如何判断这是我超龄超然进步的一方面呢？还是说我不负责任的体现呢？ Obeisance to Guru.When I start practice the Krishna consciousness, other people said I'm not care about the material things. And when I study the material skills, I'm not good as before. So sometimes the false ego is cheating us. I'm still a neophyte devotee. I want to know, in this condition, whether it's my spiritual advancement or I'm not responsibility for the material things.
Well, I don't know. We have to see how your spiritual life is. I cannot judge your spiritual life just by your description. You know, I'd have to see more about how you perform your sadhana and how much you're involved in spiritual practice.
我不知道你的这个情况到底是灵性进步还是说不负责任。我不能通过你描述你对这些事情不在乎了就判断你的灵性进步。我要看你的这个 sadhana 规范修习是一种什么样的情况才可以判断。
Now you say you're just a new devotee.So, a new devotee, it's unlikely that you're very spiritually advanced.
你描述你是一个很新的奉献者，一个很新的奉献者，通常情况下不是很进步的。
So, it may not be Krishna's arrangement, it may be simply due to your own material consciousness.
这或许不是 Krishna 的这种安排。只是你个人的物质的想法。
We devotees often have the tendency that we say, "Oh, it's Krishna. It's all Krishna. It's all Krishna's arrangement. Krishna did it." If something goes well, you know, we want to take the credit. When something doesn't go well, then we give the blame to Krishna.
有些奉献者经常会说，哦，一切都是 Krishna 的安排。当一些事情做得很好的时候，当一些事情做得很好的时候，when everything goes well,
woman ran away. She, and me, I did it because I did it. I'm the doer.
Okay. 当一切做得很好的时候，我认为这是我自己做成的。当一切做得不是很好的时候，我认为这是，然后我就声称这一切都是 Krishna 的安排。
So we have to try to be a good instrument in the service of Krishna. Whatever you do, all that you do, do it for Krishna.
因此，我们应该尝试着变成 Krishna 的一个工具。无论你做什么，不做什么，一切都看作是为 Krishna 而做。
No, sometimes you know.We have to consider our own ability. Some things we're qualified to do and some things we're not qualified to do. Some of us, you know, certain things I can't do, you know, but other people can do them, but I'm hopeless with them. But maybe it's like that. Maybe it's, you have some you know, you're not meant to be doing certain things. I don't know.
我们做任何事情都是根据我们的能力。有些时候这些事情我可以做，这些事情我不可以做。你这种表现有可能是这些事情你开始做不了了，我并不知道，我不太确定你的这个情况。
Yeah, you have to know more about your own nature. What is actually suited for you? What kind of activities are good for you?
你得了解你自己的这个本性，你知道什么事情你可以做，什么事情你可以做好。
Everyone has a nature. We're born with certain abilities, and we have certain things which we can't do also.
每一个人都有自己的本性，有一些我们可以做，有一些我们也做不了。
So we have to try to work according to our own ability.
我们的工作是根据我们的能力，在这个基础上去做。
But time and circumstance, sometimes you have to do something, even though you may not be very good at it, still you should try to, maybe you have to do it.
在某种情况或某种特定的时间 一种情况下，有些事情你虽然做不了，但是你必须不得不做 去做这件事情。
So even though sometimes you in the beginning you can't do something very well, but if you keep trying to do it gradually you may get better.
有一些事情或许你在开始的时候你做的并不是很好，但是随着做你就会做得越来越好。
Some things take more practice.
有一些事情需要花很多的练习。
We have to have the desire also.
同样也得要我们的愿望。
Okay, any other question?
还有问题吗？
我没有问题了 ，No more question.
Okay. So maybe we'll stop here tonight.
好的。
No more questions. So, thank you very much. Thanks, Om Geshe Subuddhi Rai Prabhu, Ki Om Fani, Om Geshe Sati Tujra.Can she saw the function that went went he? Woman, you for man? So how, Damodar, you at? Woman, how you, Shetian? How many days? How you, Dojang Shetian?
7 days, I think. No, 9 days.
How you, Jotian? Okay, so everyone, Junbi, how?Damodar Yu, Kwaitiya Shu, Jiyu, Jiyu, Tien. So how, Gongfang Damodar, Chang Damodar Go, Gongfang Yigadang. Juni, Damodar Yu, Kwaila, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Sati Manaji, 这最后一个问题要问吗？
OK.
问 Guru 还有没有时间，或者我们留到下次也可以。
可以问，有时间。
好的，
也是刚刚那个妈的经，顶拜咕噜。当我的某些灵性祈祷不是物质的愿望没有得到满足时，我就是认为 Krishna 没有在帮我，没有给我仁慈。这种心态是对 Krishna 一种冒犯吗？如何在 Krishna 没有满足我们灵性祈祷时看到 Krishna 的仁慈呢？
哦、
oh.。A basis to Gurudev.When I pray to the Lord, my material desire are not satisfied. I think Krishna are not helping me, not giving me the mercy. I want to ask, this mood is offense to the Krishna?
Well, it's not the right mood.
当然，这不是一个很正确的心态，不是一个正确的心态。
We should think that I'm not worthy to receive Krishna's mercy.
我们应该想，我们不值得，我们我们不值得去得，我们不被值得得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
We should think it's my problem. I'm not qualified, therefore I can't do it.
这是我的问题，所以我没有做到。
Right. We have to be. We take the blame ourselves. We don't put the blame on Krishna.
我们把这个责任应该承接到自己身上，我们不应该去责怪 Krishna.
Anyway, because I'm fallen, because I'm unqualified, therefore I'm in this situation.
因为我非常的堕落，因为我非常的不够资格，所以我才在这种处境之下。
It's not a big offense, but you don't want to be blaming or criticizing, you know, Krishna. We must keep a favorable mood of loving devotion and surrender to Krishna.
嗯，sorry，Gurudev.
We must keep a favorable mood of loving devotion.
我们总保持着我们的好的这种心态。爱着，然后以 Krishna 的愿望。
Right, you want to surrender. We want to have love for Krishna. So if we're, you know, complaining to him, why it's like this, why like that? This is not the right mood. This is not devotee.
我们应该爱和臣服 Krishna, 而不应该去责备 Krishna, 哦，为什么我会在这样的处境下，为什么我会这样，这不是一个好的心态。
All right, we want to keep the, you know, accept whatever Krishna's plan is for us. We should think Krishna must have some other plan for me.
我们接受 Krishna 给我们的这种一切的安排和计划， Krishna 一定对我们有所。有安排的。
Yeah, Krishna's got plans for all of us. So if we're not able to do something, Krishna must have a plan. That must have a good reason for it.
如果我们不能做一些什么事情的话，一定是 Krishna 的安排。Krishna 一定会安排，会有别的什么事情。
But we should remain surrendered to Krishna.
我们应该保持臣服向。对于 Krishna 保持臣服。
The Krishna is the controller. He's the overseer. He's the manager. We're just the servants.
Krishna 是见证者，是管理者，我们只是他的仆人。
Just let us serve wherever he wants us to serve.
只是去服务他希望我们去服务的，因为他希望我们去服务，我们因此只是去服务就行。
Don't be complaining, don't be finding fault with Krishna.
不要抱怨，不要去找 Krishna 的错误。
You know, it may not seem very good for you at the beginning, but after some time then you will feel that actually it's the best, that Krishna knew the best, what's best for us.
在开始的时候或许对你并不是那么好，但是过一段时间你之后你会发现，这是 Krishna 对我最好的安排。
Just like Prabhupada was preaching, now some of the God brothers, after the Guru died, after Prabhupada's Guru died, some of the God brothers, they were all fighting to get the property.
就像圣帕帕德的情况，传教一样，当圣帕帕德临行导师离开身体之后。他的那些神兄弟们就开始争斗。
You know, the different people say, I want this temple is mine, this land is mine, this building is mine.
有一些人说，这个庙宇是我的，这个建筑物是我的，这些财产是我的。
But Prabhupada didn't worry about the guru's property. Prabhupada just preached.
但是圣 大帕腾没有去考虑他宁信导师的这些财产，他只是去传教。
And Prabhupada was successful because he concentrated on the main work of the guru, which was preaching.
他只是去传教，因为他 guru 的主要的工作是传教。
He didn't worry about the property. He didn't want to just sit comfortably in the temple or in the building.
他没有考虑他姑姑的财产，也没有想着舒适的住在他姑姑的这些庙宇和建筑物之中。
So sometimes, you know, it may seem that we're not getting a very good deal, a very good situation, but in the end, ultimately, we will see that actually it's the best.Krishna knows what's best for us.
在有些情况，我们确实可能处境不是特别的好，但是在最终的时候，我们会发现这是最好的。
嗯哼。
Then she asked, when the Krishna not satisfy our spiritual prayers, how to in this condition see the Krishna's mercy?
Well, we have to see that if Krishna doesn't give you your prayer, then that is also Krishna's mercy.
我们应该看到，如果 Krishna 没有满足你的这种灵性的祈祷的话，这就是 Krishna 的仁慈。
We should be grateful that Krishna knows what is good for us.
我们应该感激 Krishna 知道什么对我们是最好的。
We're thinking, I want this. So if it's actually important, Krishna would give it. Krishna knows everything.
我们会认为这些东西是重要的，但是 Krishna 如果觉得这些东西是对你有好的，他会给你一切。
You don't have to be worried. Just have faith in Krishna.
你不必要担心，你只需要对 Krishna 有信心就行。
Krishna knows what's good for us. Just surrender.
Krishna 知道什么对我们很好，我们只是去臣服。
Material life. Sometimes we think, you know, I want this. Krishna, or Krishna didn't hear my prayer.Krishna heard he heard your prayer, he knows. Krishna knows, but Krishna knows what is actually important, what is actually good for us.
有些时候我们祈祷，我们觉得需要这个。Krishna 实际上是听到了这些，但是 Krishna 也知道什么东西对我们是最好的。Krishna 也知道。
So you have to have more faith and trust in Krishna's plan.
我们应该更有信心，更相信 Krishna 的计划。
I'm sure after some time, then you'll realize what Krishna did was right. It was good for you. It just needs time. You will see in the future.
我很确定，我确定过一段时间之后，你会看到这 Krishna 对你的这个安排，你会看到 Krishna 对你的这个安排是最好的，你只需要一些时间而已。
Yes. Okay. Is that the question?
Okay. Yes.
All right. So we'll stop here. So thank Mataji for her question. Very nice.So we wish,
谢谢你的问题，非常好的问题。
We wish her well. We wish her good luck in her devotional service.
我们希望你好，在你的奉献服务中很好。
We hope everything will turn out well for her.
我们希望一切对你是会越来越好。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.